In order to finish the lesson about the different ways how you can trim and cut geometry, we just discussed several methods how we can do it with polygonal geometry. We should also check some operators which are very, very old school and partly obsolete, but sometime might be useful for working with NURBS. We're going to speak about SurfSect, CurveSect, Project and Trim. Let's start with CurveSect. Like you might understand from the name, this operator can check some intersection of curves. And curves are logically meant NURBS or Bezier. It needs two inputs. One is 3D faces to intersect, and second, 3D faces or surface to intersect with. So basically, let's say we have some geometry which we want to intersect, and I would start with something like text. I will just write a name of my course, how to touch, and then I want to intersect it with some interesting shape. I will bring here the grid, add some details, turn it to the NURBS. Here I also want to have output open polygons, and then I will increase the level of detail, so maybe something like 50 by 50, and I will drop here some noise animation. Then we also make a geometry viewer, and let's adjust the position and sizes. So now text is just too big, so let's make it 0.2. Let's make it oriented to the center. So now we have fitted two objects, so I can increase the size of the grid a bit. And on the end, I won't visualize what is coming from the CurveSect. You don't see anything. That's because we need to visualize points. You can see that CurveSect is generating the closest point on the second surface on the intersection position. So let me, for example, increase the density, and you can see these moving points. So that is basically the work of this operator. If we check more detailed, we can find several parameters, find all intersections, tolerance, then method, what we do, we can cut or extract. In that case, we just generating new points. Then you can check it for both inputs. You can extract points, extract lines, keep original or cut. And in case of cut, you can keep all, keep one part of the curve, second part of the curve. So quite useful operator, actually. Okay, let's continue now with the next operator, and logically it will be SurfSect. And how it might be obviously from the name, it's calculating intersection between surfaces. Okay, so basically, if you just check to the parameters, we can see here it looks like a boolean for the spline surfaces. So let me make just something like torus, and let me make something like sphere. Then I should change the torus primitive type to NURBS, the same for sphere, and just connect it here, and then we can see the results. Can briefly check the parameters. So we have two options: boolean or generate profiles. Generate profiles mean generate a curve on intersection between two spline surfaces, which are very special type of primitive, which are actually kind of curves living inside of NURBS surface. That is important to understand, to know, to get the next information I will provide after this part. And boolean, which is actually generating the something more complex than just one shape, because it's not polygons, and because of the structure of the NURBS topology, it's impossible So in order to make this, you can see we have still two NURBS surfaces and four profiles. Basically, in order to understand completely how it's working, we should learn a bit of theory. This is a kind of NURBS surface. I visualize it with parallel and perpendicular lines because it's always like that. Then we can generate a profile curve, which is a curve living in 2D coordinates of UV coordinates of the NURBS surface. So that's U, that's V. All these lines are basically coordinates. And that profile is living inside, is kind of subcomponent of this geometry. And then that was used before all modern technologies with NURBS in order to be able to model holes, for example. It was used something called trim, where you just can cut the visualization of NURBS surface by the profile curve. And then you just decide, do you want to visualize inside or outside? So basically what that NURBS boolean is doing, it's doing two trimmed geometries. And we can check here the type of geometry is generating. You can see that all control vertices are still existing because actually geometry is not deleted, it's just not visualized. So that is a bit complex, but that is the nature of splines. And because we already know the theory, we can actually understand how that's working. So basically, if I just copy and paste that SurfSect and replace boolean by generate profiles, then I can use the trim operator to trim that geometry. And here you have option to keep outside or inside. So basically that's a part of operation before. And we always have an option untrim, which can turn the geometry to the full visualization mode. So basically, I would not say we are going to use so much of splines in real-time graphics, but sometimes it's very useful. And last operator for today is project. This is another way how we can generate the profile curve. So basically, if we have some surface, even just a grid, and some other curve, let's say just a circle, so we turn both geometries to the NURBS or Bezier mode, then using project we can generate the profile curve. We're projecting the circle on the surface. That is very powerful operator. We will speak about it even more in some other lesson, but now we just want to make the basic functionality. So now I have projected. We can check it with middle mouse button and see that we have two profiles. And after that, we can also use the trim. And as you can see, the trim is trimming outside or inside. So similar to the example before. That's all for today. Next week, we're going to continue to speak about different methods to subdivide geometry. And as usual, I invite you to visit our website, subscribe to our newsletter, because we're going to send some new free lessons about TouchDesigner, Houdini, Bitwig, and some other stuff. And also, you will be always up to date about our interviews and new courses, workshop, and different other events. So stay with us, stay with me, and keep power for your creative work.